there's the freaky Doppler music. And there's apparently a giant eyeball in the background. That's how I talk. I always talk when I'm stroking my chin. Otherwise, the words won't come out. And so there's Bit and Bite. And they're the main henchmen. So Doppler's like, hey, go grab X and bring him here if you kick his ass. But they totally don't do that. They fight you to the death. They don't care about capturing you. Mysterious Maverick. So, we all know who this motherfucker is. It couldn't be more obvious who he is, unless we'd never played a Mega Man X game ever. And if we haven't, then why the fuck are we playing this rare-ass Mega Man X 3 game? A game I've never seen in person in my life, except for once at Blockbuster, like 15 years ago. Back when Blockbuster still existed. So, yeah, still can't believe that Maverick Hunter defeated my master twice in the past. Which we all know what that's alluding to. He's being controlled by Sigma. Was he under Sigma's alliance all along? Or did Sigma just fucking take over him later? I guess we'll never know. Until about 20-30 minutes when I go kick his ass. Neon Tiger. Neon Tiger reminds me a lot, and he kind of fights a lot like Neo Sigma from Mega Man X 2. He's a boss. He's actually pretty tough. Like, I had to fight him a bunch of times before you really get the hang of how he works. Because it's sort of like fighting, I don't know, like someone like Skull Man or something from Mega Man X, or Ring Man, really, from Mega Man 4, where just really hard to predict bullshit. But once you get it, it's not so bad. I mean, look, I haven't found any life ups yet. I'm still in my original life. I do have 3 E-tanks that are completely empty, though. Little help that fucking does. Ah, you fucker. See, I hate that enemy, like, so much, because I don't think there's anything you can do that kills them in one shot. But I just hate them so much. Grab that so I can start charging my E-tanks a little bit. Which I'll probably come nowhere near to filling them by the end of the game. But luckily, if I do this right, I won't really need them. I'll need maybe 1, maybe 2, and I could probably fill 2 by the end of the game. Unless I have to fucking spam. Okay, I can't change weapons, apparently. So let's do it this way. I don't know if that's a bug or if that's, you know, a design. Where you can't change weapons at all unless all of your projectiles are gone. So there's Dr. Light. And this is the charge shot. You can only get to that wall with that that attack, which I think there's only a couple other instances where there are breakable walls like that. None of it's all that important. There is another move that will usurp this move, but it requires this attack, so that's why I'm getting the charge attack. So basically, this boss and the last boss that I fought, Neon Tiger, Tunnel Rhino, I fought them less because they make the game easier than I fought them because I need their power-ups that are just happen to be in their stages. So, yeah. It's kind of weird pacing. I'm deliberately making the game more difficult for myself than it has to be for the sake of precautionary measures against the, against protecting, preserving the best end of the game, in my opinion. Because, based on who you fight and kill at this stage of the game will affect the ending. Not so much in the cutscenes or anything like that, but just what bosses you get to fight. So, just want to demonstrate all the stuff that you can expect. Now, here's the thing. Little charge shots, little double charge shots. The first thing with the little spiral orbs of weirdness, those do a sick amount of damage. Your regular charge shot, the full blast, doesn't do a whole lot. So, the trick is to try to hit them with one or both of those little orb blast parts, because that's where all the damage is. It's kind of weird. Still not nearly as much as the Z-Saber, but we can't all be zero. Look at that shit. Killed him in no time. The hardest part isn't really killing him, it's just dodging all of his fucking bombs bouncing around. Just, as soon as you destroy one, it pops out another one. You don't even give a fuck. And all the bosses, they drop one little mini health item as a little compensation, because this isn't a checkpoint. I don't think it is. I think that one might be a checkpoint, but in most cases, it's not a checkpoint. You still have to go through like a bunch of the level before you hit a checkpoint. It's ridiculous. So, keep my shot charged up just in case. Aw, you fucker. Look at this. I got deflected by some shit while I was standing inside of his body. I don't know what's going on. See, you have to... It's so finicky because he's using those fucking maces. Just pull out that shit. How you like that? There. You happy? Well, I know I'm happy. No, that's not... Oh. I thought I was at the end of the stage. But no, I'm only halfway done. This would be where Bite and Bit would be if they chose to attack you here. Which they did not, apparently, so... No worries. I don't think there's a pattern to it. I think it's completely random. But I could be wrong. So, these spikes that they're creating, I don't think they will instantly kill you, but I'm not in a hurry to find out. They do considerable damage if they hit you, though. As does pretty much everything else in the game. I'm at the end of the stage. I got one life up. And I don't think I can kill this guy with just my pathetic amount of life that I have. And I don't even have one full E-Tank, so... This probably isn't gonna go well. I'll probably have to kill myself so I can preserve a victory here. I'll give it a gold college try, I guess. See, this is actually why charging up all the way is not the best strategy here. Because the first shot is really slow, and he just blocks it. You have a very small window of time to hit him with. Unless he's firing shit at you. Or he's hanging on the wall. It'll get so much worse. I think I can do this. I'm already doing it. He's kind of unpredictable. You never know what he's going to do. You know, the most predictable thing... Oh, he's doing it. He's charging at me. She's also has an invulnerability move. It's kind of hard to... Oh, see? What the fuck? Ridiculous. It's almost not even worth it to use a charge shot anymore. I'm just fucking wailing a regular blast. Almost got him. I don't want to... I hit the wrong button. These buttons are so bad. I don't know what... Let's get back to the... I'll try without... Okay, I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna make sure I got this. Yeah, that probably would have killed me anyway, so... But would I have died if I didn't pause the game? I don't know. At least he's dead. That's all that matters. Preserved a victory without having to sacrifice a life. And that's one more guy to take down. Neon Tiger's move is pretty good. It's not very effective against a lot of things. It's like a cool little spark. It's like a bedazzler shotgun. So now that I have that, I can go fight Gravity Beetle. Because Gravity Beetle, he's not really hard to kill, but I can never do it at this stage of the game because he kills you in literally two shots. So. I mean, I'm not that much of a boss to dodge him the entire time with just regular buster attacks. But if you use the gravity shot, the little sparklers on him, he goes down in no time. So there's a superfluous amount. Aww. See how cheap to make all these enemies? Like, oh, you're gonna dodge if I just stand from down there? No, we're gonna give him fucking projectiles to hit you from any angle. It's ridiculous. Every enemy is like that in this game. Every enemy can hit you anywhere you are. But you can't always hit them, because you can only shoot one way. Oh, no. There's Bit. Such an asshole. I have my orders here to be destroyed. Those were not your orders. I was there. For some reason. Oh, he's got so much life. Oh, God. He's like a combination. Ah, damn it. You have to psych him out, or else you'll never win. He's also weak to, like, the stupidest, hardest to hit move, because the speed. He's like a combination of Vile and, I was able to dodge under that. Basically, just don't want to get hit by the rings. Those are your... Also not get hit by him. Those are your two objectives. This is going very well. And it only gets worse the longer this goes on. I don't know if you can tell, but this is way harder than it looks. But, you have to use that specific move. If you don't kill him with this move, the icicle attack, then he won't die. He'll just disappear, and you have to fight him again later. So if you want to change how the game, how the end game works, you have to beat him with the ice move. And then when I fight Bite, whenever that is, you have to fight him with the drill. Which Bite is kind of hard to kill anyway, so it's in your best interest to use the drill on him anyway. There's a hidden move. Big F tank, which is, that's the frog. At least I assume it stands for frog. The frog, riding armor, which is completely useless. I can never figure out the controls, how it works, for all this time. You only need them for like two spots in the game, and they're both really useless. Can never get it to navigate. It always falls in a pit. Alright. Aww. That was bullshit. So basically, it took all the enemies, the types of enemies you'd expect to fight from like Mega Man X, and they put them in here, but they make them take way more fucking bullets. So they're not even fun to fight anymore. I don't know. Oh, I'm totally gonna die. That was bullshit. What did I get hit by? Alright. So now... I do like the fact that it's weird that when you upgrade the Buster Charge, the charge shots on Mega Man X's, you can immediately climb ladders much faster for some reason. I don't know what sense that makes, but... That's what happens, apparently. I missed the fucking tram. So... Since I can't jump worth a crap... I'm gonna catch the next one. And of course the shit fucking respawns. So, there, I'm doing that. I'm doing it. So many of these guys. I get hit by the worst shit. Again. Yeah, fuck it. Going for this. You're an asshole. You don't even need to hit him. You need to get close to him. Just fucking touched by his aroma. His fucking perfume does damage to you. I don't know why a robot would have perfume, but it does. I think if you go up to that area that I just passed by, if you go up in the sky, you can get a riot armor. But since I don't have the riot armors, I can't use it yet. Because all I picked up was an alternate version of the original, but you have to unlock the original first to be able to use it. Which I'm not going to do for a little while, because I don't like going to that stage. It takes a while. So actually why I'm doing this stage, so I can do that stage. Alright, so I can't go through there because I don't have the riding armors yet. But even then, I don't want to, because that's where one of the chip upgrades are. And you only have one, like I mentioned before, so I'm not going to do that. You have to avoid all the chips to be able to get all of them. That makes any sense. So look at this. You get hit by one, so it knocks you down to respawn the other. It's just cruel and unusual. Pull up my race sparkler. Just like a shotgun. Automatic shotgun of lights. I don't even get what it's supposed to be. What the fuck am I shooting at? Am I shooting, like, Christmas lights at him? Is this guy Jewish? Is that why he's weak against it? Just, like... It's like I'm deflating a balloon in his face. I don't know why it makes that sound whenever you shoot a guy or you hit these guys, like... It's like I'm punching Jell-O. Maybe that's what these guys are made of. They're robots made out of Jell-O. I don't know. I'm not here to judge. So he's exploding all over the place. And I got the gravity power. Oh, he's so annoying if you wanted to fight him head on. Because not just the gravity, but... does a fuck ton of damage. It's so annoying.